We're lifting up holy hands without wrath or doubt. In the sanctuary of the Lord, all to praise you, magnify you, Lord. We're lifting up holy hands. Good morning. And God bless you. Welcome to your 5-minute spiritual checkup. I am Evangelist Kelly Harrison. Romans 8:6 reads as follows. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. A carnal mind is one that seeks to gratify the flesh. It is selfish and refuses to take orders from the law of God. Too many people claim to be Christians, but they are merely carnal Christians. Many movie stars, athletes, musicians will claim to be followers of Christ, but their actions say something different. A person who is spiritually minded follows God's word. You see them obeying the commandments of God. You see them loving their brethren. You see them loving their enemy. You see them upholding a standard of holiness, where the carnal Christian will party and use drugs and alcohol and sexual immorality. To be carnally minded is death. It is separation from God. To be carnally minded is serving Jesus so you think, but you're on your way to hell. To be spiritually minded is to walk in the way that God has commanded. And you are not condemned. Romans 8:1 says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. We who are spiritually minded have no condemnation. We are not under disapproval, but we instead have the approval of the Most High God. So ask the Lord, am I carnal? Or am I spiritual? And if you find yourself to fall short, ask the Lord for forgiveness. And then begin to obey His word. Be not a nominal Christian, but an actual Christian. Father God, you are great and marvelous and worthy of all praise. Lord, we ask right now that you forgive us, Lord, for falling short of what you have called us to do. You have asked that we be spiritually minded and not carnal, but we have allowed the world to interfere with our worship of you. And Because of this, we have been drawn away from you. But Lord, we ask right now, forgive us our sins and blot out all of our transgressions. Remember those who do not know you. Allow us to reach them with your word. Lord, let them come to know you and to also be a spiritual Christian. Lord, in everything we do, we want our ways to please you. So we ask that you would let the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. In Jesus' matchless name I pray. Amen. If you have enjoyed this devotion, please like, subscribe, and tell someone else about this channel.